And Itzik, the president is gone, and now I can tell you that he talked about you in third person. And it sounded to me more like a eulogy. Then I saw the flowers and got really concerned. But then I looked at you, and you were there, happy and smiling. I calmed down. I don't, just say it. Okay, well, it's time to conclude. Time to conclude a special symposium. It's a unique symposium because it did not have a focused scientific title, nor a common thread connecting all the talks. But the speakers are all connected. They are united in coming here to celebrate with you your birthday and to salute you for your scientific accomplishments. It is not surprising that a great deal of the topics that were discussed here revolved around the cancer microenvironment. It was an idea that arose in your mind when you were still young, still an immunologist working on tumor-bound immunoglobulins, but then developed into a concept and evolved into a paradigm and became a discipline and a research field that is now divided into a number of subfields, like the immunomicroenvironment, the inflammomicroenvironment, the metastomicroenvironment, the angiomicroenvironment. The bottom line is that tumor immunology, tumor immunity, tumor-related angiogenesis, inflammation-driven cancer, the metastatic process, and so on and so forth, cannot be studied today, but in the light of the tumor microenvironment. Now, you gave credit to Stephen Paget, who began this many years ago with the seed and soil theory, which was neglected for nearly a century. And I like to add to him Rudolf Virchow. He was a contemporary of him, and he wrote, "Cancer arises at sites of chronic inflammation." He wrote it in German, not in English, so maybe they have not communicated at that time. But sites translates today as microenvironment. And chronic irritation, he said chronic irritation is chronic inflammation. So I, just like them, I know you have a hard time to push forward your ideas because you thought about them at a time when most scientists believe that cancer is a genetic disease. Now I know that we have here protagonist of that idea sitting on the front row, so I won't argue with them. But I want to read the short paragraph that they took from one of those slides, which fortunately you have not shown today. And it was written by two other protagonists of the same idea. It's Kinsler and Vogelstein. And they wrote, "Although abnormalities of cancer genes are essential contributors to cancer, most abnormalities in these genes occur relatively early in the disease process, and none are known to be specifically associated with the metastatic stage. It is this final stage, the seeding and growth of satellite lesions in other organs, that is ultimately responsible for the great majority of neoplastic death." So we have genetic and epigenetic modifications that are on one side of the equation, and they shape the malignant character, the phenotype of the cancer cells. But we had other factors that are shaping the soil. And they can be anti-cancerous if the soil is made of immune system components, cancer immunity mechanisms, and so on and so forth, but it can be shaped to become pro-malignant if it is governed by chronic inflammatory responses, which induce immunosuppression, and so on and so forth. Perhaps we should call, in the spirit of Stephen Paget, these inflammatory responses the fertilizers, because we have the soil and the fertilizers. I want to tell you about the best ever, shortest ever speech that I've ever heard. I was 10 years old, standing at the National Park of Ramat Gan. It was Tu Bishvat, our National Planting Day. I was among maybe 800 school children, each holding a plant in his hand on the podium. 20 dignitaries, in the middle was Avraham Krenitsi. He was the mayor of Ramat Gan at that time. And he said in his heavy Russian accent, six words, Yeladim Yekarim, Atem Ashtilim Ve'anachnu Azzevel. So in Hebrew it sounds much better, but Zevel means fertilizer, and obviously chronic inflammation is Zevel, Tartei Mashma. I say it because Paget's language was rich with farmers' vocabulary. Okay, if you look in his Lancet paper that you have cited, the original paper about the seed and soil theory, he writes something like that. So far, the best work in the pathology of cancer is done by those studying the nature of the seed. They are like scientific botanists. Maybe he looks down at them already at that time. But he who turns over the records of cancer can be only the ploughman. Not only is observations of the soil useful, they provide essential information without which we will not be able to understand the metastatic process, which is the most important ingredient in determining the outcome of the disease. Now, Isik, you are the ploughman. And the metastatic process is now under the limelight, both in your laboratories and other laboratories, because this process is determining the outcome of the disease, and it depends not only on the seed, but perhaps more and more on the soil. Perhaps even in cases of cancers that are not driven by chronic inflammation, okay, metastatic lesions develop at sites of chronic irritation, chronic inflammation. It can be in the lung, it can be in the liver, it can be in the brain. And I would like to see more and more studies focusing on a metastatic niche as a site of chronic inflammation, microenvironmental chronic inflammation. I know you are doing it in Lundab. I know some more laboratories are doing it. Perhaps we'll hear more about that next year on the 7th Cancer Microenvironment Conference that will be held here in Tel Aviv, October 2015, which is organized and chaired by Isaac Witz. Isaac told me that after that conference, he wants to retire from the presidency of the Cancer Microenvironment Society, and I think we should reject this appeal already at this time. You know, age is not a good reason for retirement. Mandatory retirement is an invention of modern society. Now, the true essence of retirement has been depicted perhaps more than 1800 years ago in the Mishnah by Rabbi Tarfon, who said and then wrote, "Lo alecha amelacha ligmor, ve'en ata ben chorin leibatel mimela." It is not your duty to complete the work, but neither are you free to desist from it. So you have been blessed with a wonderful family, children and grandchildren, students and grand students who walk in your step and complete the work that you have initiated alongside with you. I wish you no retirement, many, many more accomplishments and strides. Now, having many friends and students and family notwithstanding, you need only one, perhaps two at the utmost, to organize such a successful symposium. And the first one on the list is Yona Kaysari, our last speaker, who has been involved in organizing this symposium over the past year. Thank you, Yona, for letting it happen. And the last one on the list is Smadar Fischer, She is not an official scientist, but a great fan of the tumor microenvironment. And I can assure you that if she is involved in organizing the next conference in Tel Aviv, she will do a good job. Yeah. Orit, I didn't know, so Orit as well, thank you. Orit is a PhD student of Yitzhak and still in the lab, right? So you see, people stick to you. Thank you, Isaac. Thank you all for joining us today.